Well, Bad Jews is a hilarious comedy. It's about two cousins, Daphne and Liam, and they're both Jewish, and their grandfather, the patriarch of the family, has unfortunately just passed away. He kept with him a very, very precious memento, which he's kept with him all his life, and now that he's passed away, both of the cousins really, really want this memento. And it kind of leads to this really interesting and very, very funny acerbic, witty, riotous comedy.
I'm the non-Jew coming into this Jewish family, and she's a delight. She's just full of love and life and energy for everyone, and just wants everyone to get along, and sadly, they don't.
Yeah, so Bad Jews did really well in New York. They sold out their previews. They had rave reviews. It did incredibly well in the West End as well. And we're really excited to bring it to Australian audiences, especially at a new theatre here in St Kilda.
It was only supposed to be on for about 2 months, and it was proved so popular that extended, probably, I think it went up for a year in New York. Similar thing happened in West End recently. Last year they opened up with a 2 month season and it went for 8 months.
Yeah, Bad Jews is a hilarious family comedy, so it's really relatable, and I think people will get a lot of laughs first and foremost.
It's for you. It's funny and it's full of love and laughter, and it's a great night at the theatre. Great writing, very witty, quick.
I think people are going to be really, really entertained. I think they're going to be maybe a little bit offended, but, you know, in a kind of fun, naughty way.
And come see why it is proving to be one of the most produced plays in the world and making everybody laugh hysterically.
Back on the Shtick, we're here with a very lovely actress. Her name's Maria Angelico. And we didn't tell everybody that I knew your parents in the day.
Yes!
In the early 80s, when I met you at the after party at the opening, we've just seen a little clip of the show, and before that, the opening night, where there was a fantastic spread of Jewish, by the way, the chicken soup.
Oh my goodness.
Wasn't that good chicken soup?
I think I had three in a row.
I had four, I think. And so your parents are Sam Angelico and yes. Peaches la Crème.
Correct.
Who are associates of a very, very funny, neurotic Jewish guy. He is the worst Jew I know. Henry Mars, whose mother had Mars Cafe at St Kilda Junction when I was young, when we were kids at school. The first cabaret, and he started the Night Cat
and the Black Cat.
Yeah. And he was lived in the same house as your parents.
Yeah.
In the day, when I had my antique shop, I used to go around to their place and go and see their shows. Sam Angelico's a wonderful magician and a mime. And your mother was a cabaret star in her day.
Yeah.
And so you've inherited all this fantastic genetic madness.
Yeah, with or without choice, it's been handed down to me.
Yes, and you've got two older sisters. One's a singer.
Yeah. And the other's a painter and a fine artist. A fine artist, yeah.
And you've actually studied acting.
Yeah.
In Melbourne and New York.
Correct, yeah.
And you're mainly a theatre person.
Yeah.
That's your shtick? Or you've done a lot of television?
I think I've done probably more film and television, but I love theatre as well. Yeah, I love them both. I think any kind of performing and even writing, I really enjoy. Yeah.
And even writing?
Yeah.
So have you got anything going on?
Yeah, I wrote a series that's being released in November. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Comedy, yeah.
Comedy series?
Comedy series about dance therapy.
Okay, yeah, dance therapy. I've been living on dance therapy all my life.
Yes, so
that's the reason why I'm so fit and healthy, because I love dancing.
Yeah,
when
cool.
Any opportunity to get me there, I'll dance.
Great.
And so the other thing that I wanted to talk to you about is neurosis.
Yes. Yeah.
Whoa. Why are we all so crazy?
Yeah.
hung up about our culture, because you've got a cultural background.
Yes.
But yours was very mixed up. Yes. In a sense, you didn't have the definitive Jewish thing
that we have. And I wasn't raised, I went to a Catholic school, but I didn't have that. I had a quite loose upbringing in regards to a rigid kind of religious and cultural background. But going back to the play and Bad Jews, the character I'm playing is very very neurotic and it really explores that kind of, I guess, archetype or character of that neurotic Jewish.
And also having the Holocaust connection.
Yeah.
I think that's a really big one that we've discovered lately, that it passes down. All that, all the stress and the tension of being through that, the trauma.
And I think there is, you know, I think whatever, you know, especially something as traumatic as the Holocaust, it can't not be passed on because our it affects our behaviour and our behaviour affects our children and then, you know, we hold on to things and... But with all families, I think, when there's trauma, it's so easily passed through to children and they carry it on. It's how we manage that and how that is translated into modern culture as well, which is... Because it's different for someone like my character growing up in Pennsylvania in modern day, having the tension and the trauma of a Holocaust survivor. You know, it's interesting,
Very much so. Well, it's been really great to have you on the show, and I know that you've got something, a launch tonight at the Astor Theatre of a series that's going to go on air soon.
Yeah, it's called Footballer Wants Wife. It's a takeoff of all those awful reality and TV
shows. It is a comedy.
Yes, it's a comedy. Yes.
It's a total and utter hilarity. And we're going to say farewell to you. Thank you so much, Maria. We could go on about this because
I know we
need to get a couch, right? And psychoanalyze you and me. We need some psychoanalysis, particularly after having to play that Duffner part. And so we're going to take you out of this segment with a lady called Tal Ben-Ari, who was my favourite artist on the night of Sheer Madness. Now, Sheer Madness has just finished in Melbourne. I'm still recovering. And we're going to go into the next segment with highlights of the day at the Classic Cinema and the Big Marquee. And there were some wonderful acts, especially the finale of the show was just wild, and Monsieur Camembert. And I'll have you back.
Cool,
please come back.
It would be my pleasure. Thanks.
Thank you. See you after the break.